we decided to make the improvement of the school lunchroom a class project. The enthusiasm we've all felt for the idea should make us hopeful that we can do a good job. Now today, our task is to organize ourselves. But before we do that, I have some pleasant news. Bill, will you tell us what you said to me this morning?
Well, yesterday afternoon, on my way home from basketball practice, I ran into Mr. Williams, our principal. I told him what we were discussing in class. He said the improvement of the lunchroom was a swell thing for us to work on. He was very much interested and said that he'd be glad to help us in any way that he could.
Wow.
Well, that's fine, Bill. And now we're ready to hear what you've been thinking.
I'd like to do something about making the lunchroom more attractive.
How would I?
I've read about soundproofing. Maybe that could make the lunchroom quieter.
I was thinking if the pupils had some games or recreation after they get through eating, they wouldn't get into mischief.
Could I work on that?
I'd like to work on that, too.
Maybe we could have a cleanup squad to make the students pick up the papers they throw on the floor.
Nah, that wouldn't be any good. The kids wouldn't like it.
I can see you've been thinking and have some good suggestions. But before we get too many ideas, suppose we first make a list of things that are wrong in the lunchroom. George, will you go to the board, please? Give us one, Bill.
Litter on the floor.
All right, George, write that down. What else?
Noise.
Now that we know the things we have to take care of, what committees do we need?
Well, couldn't we have a committee for each one of the things listed?
That would be a simple and logical way. George, will you figure out the names of the committees and write them on the board? Well, here they are. Five of them. Thank you, George. Now, I'm going to pass off some paper. And let's write down the one we prefer to work on. To make sure we're not all on one committee, why don't we put down our second and even third choice? We're each a member of a committee now. But committees don't work very well unless someone is made responsible for seeing that the group does its work. You'll need a chairman for that. Is there anything else?
Well, what about a secretary?
You may need a secretary to keep track of what you do. Any other suggestions?
What about a treasurer?
Well, I hardly think you'll need one. Well, what happens after we elect our officers?
Then we get to work.
Yes, that's right, but what do we do?
Well, we ought to figure out what to do.
Ah, exactly. We need a work plan. Well, let's make one, right now. Each committee has a problem. What should be the first thing to do?
Well, we should decide what information we have to get.
All right, and then?
Shouldn't we discuss how to get the information?
That's good. And don't we also have to decide who is to get the information? So I suggest that after we elect our officers, we decide, you better write this down, one, what information we will need, two, how we will get the information, three, who is to get it. Now we are ready for our committee meeting.
To do is to elect a chairman and a secretary. Are there any nominations for chairman?
I nominate George for chairman of the Noise Reduction Committee. He knows a lot about soundproofing, and I think he can help us with our work.
Are there any seconds for the nomination?
I second the nomination.
Dorothy, will you please act as secretary and write this down? Are there any other nominations?
Well, I think George would be the best one for the job.
Well, if there are no other nominations, let's vote. All those in favor of George will please raise their hands. Well, George, I guess you're chairman.
Thank you.
What are the things we want to find out in the food committee?
I'd like to try and find out why they don't have enough candy to go around.
Oh, you and your candy. That's silly. We ought to find out about the other food first.
But candy's food, too. Why can't you find out about all food?
That's a good idea. But I think we ought to talk to Luncheon Master first.
Since we're in the cleanup committee, let's find out if there are enough containers for throwing the trash away.
Don't you think we ought to find out how many trash cans we have and just where they're placed?
Yes, that's a good way to get started. Claude, will you take care of that?
Yeah, sure, I'll do that. I think we ought to see just when the lunchroom begins to get dirty. I mean, how soon after students finish eating? I'll do that if it's all right with everybody.
Sure. Are there any other suggestions?
I think I'd like to see the condition of the tables at the beginning of the lunch period, and then compare them with what they look like at the end.
That's well.
The committees made their investigations. They consulted with the teacher in charge of the lunchroom about their plans. With the aid of the lunchroom manager, the members of the food selection committee discussed the food choices of the pupils. At the food counters, the pupils were free to make their selections from the items displayed. A lot of sweets. Hardly a suitable diet for growing youngsters. Members of the cleanup committee checked on the disposal of paper and trash. The aim of a great many pupils was not always accurate. They observed the habits and practices of the students. This was a common occurrence and was much relished by all but the victims. The decoration committee consulted with the art teacher and discussed the problem of making the lunchroom more attractive. Members of other committees sought diligently for clues to solve their problems. They brought their findings to committee meetings.
Pupils don't know what kind of food they should eat, so they choose the wrong food. Mrs. Ames, the cooking teacher, gave me a good idea. If we could have posters like these set up over the food counter, they might help the kids choose the right kind of diet for their health.
That's a very good idea. And I don't think the pupils will mind having these posters up.
I think we should have a whole set of these made.
I think so, too.
I have a swell idea for the best recreation we can have after we've finished eating. We can clear away all the tables and dance.
But what about music?
We could start a swing band in school.
But I don't like to dance.
You better learn.
I'd rather play ping pong.
Who cares about ping pong? That's silly.
Maybe we could have movies.
Maybe once in a while. That's not as good as dancing.
I like to play checkers. And if there's dancing, there'll be too much noise.
Look, everybody likes to dance. You'll see. It'll be swell. Well, let me show you how we can do this.
Well, no use. He's stuck on dancing.
Yeah. Well, how are you getting along?
Okay. We have a great idea to have dancing after we're done with eating.
Have you all approved?
Well, some of the other kids have some other ideas, but they're not so good.
And have you discussed their ideas?
Well, no.
See, you know, a good chairman is one who gives each person a chance to present his thoughts. These thoughts and ideas should then be discussed by all. And then the committee, not just the chairman, decides which to accept.
Oh, I see. Well, I thought since I had such a good idea, well, all right, we'll go over some of the other suggestions made. What were they?
Checkers. Well, what do you want to do about decorating the lunchroom?
We ought to paint the whole place in bright colors and have lounge chairs like we have in restaurants.
No, that's no good. We ought to hang pictures on the wall.
And put nice curtains on the windows.
Wait a minute, I'm all mixed up now.
What's the matter, Alice?
Well, they make so many suggestions, I don't know what to do.
Well, why don't you take them up one at a time? As chairman, you have the responsibility for guiding the discussion.
All right, I see. Thank you. Now, what was your suggestion, Carol?
I think we should paint the place.
All right, would you write that down? And then we'll discuss it.
you know what day this is. Today we make our revised recommendations to the class. You may recall that last week we discussed and approved the committee's suggestion. We are very glad that Dr. Williams, our principal, was able to accept our invitation and be with us today. And now, Mildred, will you take over?
The purpose of this period is to bring to you, in final form, the plans for class to improve the school lunchroom. The speakers at this table will bring to you not only their own thoughts, but those decided upon by the committee and then approved by the class. We are very happy to have Dr. Williams with us. We hope he will like our plans. Now, Bill, may we hear your first report?
Today, after many weeks of work, we present our final report. As chairman of the cleanup committee, I'd like to say that we found conditions in the lunchroom pretty bad. The students don't seem to think there's anything wrong with throwing papers on the floor. To correct this, we suggest humorous posters. These may help. The average student takes about 20 minutes to eat. He has the rest of the period to do nothing but fool around. We met with the recreation committee, and they will give you their suggestions later as to how to use this time.
Thank you, Bill. Now, George, may we hear your report?
The noise in the lunchroom was very loud. As you know, noise is bad for digestion. The lunchroom could be soundproof, but we found that that would cost thousands of dollars, and so we gave up that idea. Another plan was suggested, playing soft music on the school phonograph. We gave up that, too. Students might not like the music played and be noisier than ever. We hope that when the pupils are occupied by the plans of the Recreation Committee, they will be quiet.
Thank you, George. Now Francis will speak for the Food Selection Committee.
We found out a lot of things about food. Many kids aren't eating what they should. They fill up on candy and don't get enough vitamins found in fresh fruits and vegetables. We'd like to put up posters like these to teach the children what they should eat.
Our next speaker is Alice, for the Decoration Committee.
We've arranged with the art department to have drawings and paintings done by the students put on the walls of the lunchroom and to have them changed every month. In this way, we will have pretty things to look at while we eat and not just bare walls.
Our last speaker is David, for the Recreation Committee.
The Recreation Committee made sort of a Gallup poll and found out what the students would like to do with their spare time during lunch period. Here are some of our suggestions. Students who would like to read or study should be given passes to the library. We think the school should buy table games like checkers, parcheesi, and maybe even chess, and let the students play with them after they finish eating. We had other ideas like dancing, movies. You probably can't do anything about them now.
Well, this is it. Now, I wonder if Dr. Williams would care to say a few words to us.
First, I want to thank you for inviting me to this meeting. I've listened to some excellent suggestions. I think that you are to be congratulated upon the good work that you've done on a problem connected with our own school community. The lunchroom manager and I have been following your project for some time with much interest, and we are now ready to cooperate with you in carrying out your plan.
The new system, developed by the students themselves and originating from a class project, aroused great interest. The decorations on the wall, the improved appearance of the room, made the pupils feel that there was something important about the lunch period that they previously had missed. The signs over the food counter were a reminder that a variety of foods were necessary for a balanced diet. Hot foods became more popular. Food selection, instead of depending on whim and ignorance, provided a lesson in proper eating habits. A changed atmosphere helped bring about a changed attitude toward behavior. But what's this? Easy now. Sure, you're not going to be a goon. That's right, you know what to do with that. Why not try a game of checkers? It's really much more fun. And the audience doesn't mind joining in either.
We have completed our project. And I think we have done a very good job. Now, before we take up our next problem in community living, let's see if we can remember how we came to undertake this project.
We were dissatisfied with lunchroom conditions.
No, that wasn't it. We were learning about taking care of public property and saw there was something we could do about our own lunchroom.
And what was the next step?
We voted on it.
Can you go on?
Then we decided on committees and formed a plan under which to work.
We held meetings and brought in ideas for improving the lunchroom.
The class then voted on our suggestions. Then we presented the plan to the principal, and he let us try it out.
Now let's think over our experience and see what we've learned.
I've learned you have to get facts before you can make things better.
I've learned it was more fun to work with others than alone.
Well, I found out it wasn't easy to be chairman. You can get more out of people when you give them a chance to tell their ideas and let them decide on which they want.
I think we changed the behavior of the students.
I don't think we changed the behavior of the students. We simply gave them things they liked to occupy themselves.
I think that's right. We didn't change the students at all. I bet if we went back to the old system, they would behave the same as they did before.
Well, I wonder if behavior isn't just like that. When conditions are improved, behavior can often be improved.
What is the function of method? Is it to teach factual material or provide experiences in solving problems and working together? The answer depends upon the educational objective, for method is the means to the end.